Welcome to GisTube TV, your home for everything entertainment. We bring celebrity lifestyle news, happenings across the world. We bring to you social events, you know, anything at all that interests you. You're going to find it on this channel. Just go through our content. You will become glued. I promise you that.
I am pressured to leave Nigeria. Who is saying this? This is not me. I'm not the one under pressure. But the presidential candidate under the Labour Party in the just concluded presidential election, Peter Obi, has said that he's under pressure to leave the country. Now, if you're an obedient or you're a lover of Peter Obi and you're wondering, why does he want to leave the country? Welcome to this channel and welcome to The Gist. The presidential candidate of the Labour Party, Peter Obi, has said that he's been pressured to leave the country, with attacks against his person emanating from different quarters. Yes, now, so in recent time, there's been a lot of things and, you know, orishirishi, different things actually happening to Peter Obi, with people coming with different allegations and stories, especially a video, a voice that actually leaked of him, of Peter Obi allegedly speaking with the founder of the Living Faith Church, Winners Chapel, Isaac Oyedepo, and, you know, him just saying, yes, daddy, basically, that was during the election campaign period before the presidential election happened, and it was just him asking for Oyedepo's support in convincing the Southwesterners and, you know, people of his church and all that to vote Peter Obi, just for Oyedepo to endorse him, basically. Now, Obi now said this in a statement on Wednesday, and he said it via his Twitter handle. He added that the leaked audio, see, that was what he was referring to. He said that the leaked audio conversation between himself and the founder of the Living Faith Church Worldwide, Bishop David Oyedepo, Isaac David Oyedepo, he says that the video is actually doctored and fake, that the audio rather is doctored and fake. The former governor of Anambra State, while referring to the recent comments of the Minister of Information, Lai Mohammed, alleged that the All Progressive Congress and the APC-led government are doing everything possible to divert attention from the violently stolen mandate, and he said it is unfortunate and sad. This is what he actually said. This is what Peter Obi said on his Twitter handle. He said, the present attempts by the APC as a party and the APC-led government through some government officials and agencies to divert our attention from our blatantly stolen mandate is unfortunate and sad. These have come and continue to manifest in different ways, such as the malicious accusation of the Minister of Information, Mr. Lai Mohammed, the circulation of a fake doctored audio call, and a pressure on me to leave the country. He continued by saying, let me reiterate that the audio call being circulated is fake, and at no time throughout the campaign and now did I ever think or even imply that the 2023 election is or was a religious war. This is what Peter Obi had to say concerning all of the brouhaha surrounding the election and him, you know, basically begging Bishop Oyedepo to, you know, make this a religious one, just convince Southwesterners to vote for somebody who is a Christian against the APC presidential candidate, then who is now the president-elect, Alhaji Ashiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, who is a Muslim and of course is vice president candidate, and who is now the vice president elect, also being a Muslim, you know, the Muslim ticket and all that. But Peter Obi is saying it's not true, and that what they are doing is going to pressure him to leave the country. So a lot of Nigerians have different reactions to him saying that he's under pressure to leave the country. Some are saying that, oh, this is showing how half-baked Peter Obi is for him to think that something like this is enough for him to leave the country, or that he really did not have, you know, what it takes to withstand all the pressure. Because while Ashiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu was actually being pressured during the campaign period, you know, people saying different things concerning the former governor of Lagos State, including how he has incontinency issues and, you know, him. There were several videos of him saying different things during the campaign that even became trending sounds, and you know, all the bullying. But at some point, the then presidential candidate was saying that, oh, he does not even look at social media anymore, because everywhere he turns to, everything he sees on social media is people abusing, people yabbing him and insulting his personality. So he's saying that he no longer even wants to watch social media. Meanwhile, during the campaign, a lot of social media users were in favor of Peter Obi, people, you know, supporting him and fighting other celebrities, other persons like themselves, you know, campaigning for another person who is not Peter Obi and all of those things. So Peter is saying that he's pressured, he wants to leave, and some others are saying, see, there is nobody without skeleton in their cupboard. While Peter Obi was trying to maintain the personality of a saint on social media and throughout the campaign period, you know, for the election that has passed, look at him now, actually was groveling, you know, behind the scenes, calling somebody yes daddy, from Renault Mokri to Lai Mohammed to Fanny Kayode. You know, a lot of persons have said things concerning Peter Obi, who competed. But now this man is in court. Court have thrown out some of his, you know, petitions and filings and all that. But he says that the mandate was blatantly taken from him, and I don't know what he's still going to do about that. But in the comment section, if you think that there's something Peter Obi can still do about the whole election results, election situations, I'd like to hear from you. And if you have different opinions, if you have a different opinion from what is trending, or if you have a hot take you want to add even to what Peter Obi has said, because really trending for us saying, guy, how can you? I mean, we understand that you're trying to say it's doctored and that's not you, and people are just saying things concerning. Somebody even said, let me just say that, just remember, somebody even said that this is actually the APC government, or, you know, supporters trying to find a reason for Peter Obi to be tried, that they want to, you know, try him for treason. I mean, I think that's wild, but I also would like to hear your take on that one. That's another school of thought. So several school of thoughts on this situation. I'd love to hear from you in the comment section. Guys, make it constructive, and also please realize that we are not by any way affiliated to any political party. This is just us bringing observations, trend and news, debates, gist, celebrity lifestyle, and everything happening across the globe for your viewing pleasure. Having said all of these things, I'm going to see you in the next video. But before I go, if this is your first time here, thank you so much for joining us. But become a part of this community by subscribing to this channel and liking this video, sharing it to people around you. I'm going to see you in the next one, though. Until then, really, really now, until then, bye for now, and bye, guys.